Today we're going to be talking about 3D printed calibration cubes with my CR10s PRO. And we're going to explain how we got from the left cube here with the wall chatter to this cube here and then to the best cube here. And then how we managed to continue and repeat this quality setting, and then how we managed to break these settings and continue improving with the broken settings, and how we still have a bunch of problems to fix before this printer can print well. So if we look at this cube right here, it was printed with a 30 millimeters per second speed and it still printed poorly. I adjusted the settings, the roller pressure and the z-axis. I played with the axis. I kind of took the printer apart to understand what's going on, and I still got this cube, which seemed to be a little bit better, but only for the first 6 millimeters of the wall. Then the wall started chattering excessively. So last week we saw that I broke down some cubes to see what's going on, and we can see that the inner wall is better than the outer wall. Simple and efficient, and because these diagonal travel lines that the nozzle left behind, we kind of figured out that if the nozzle needs to travel, then the wall doesn't look good. So what can we do to stop that travel and have the nozzle print the subsequent wall from the same point it finished the previous one? Well, that took us to the Cura settings, and it has to do with the seam and the shortest path in the seam. So basically, to get these cubes to print well, you have to choose the seam to be on the shortest path. And that ended up giving us these quality cubes right here, these two, okay? And they're a little bit better than what we used to get, okay? They're better. They're a lot better, actually, not just a little bit. And with that, we fixed the problem. But in order to fix the problem, we had to disable the jerk settings. We had to change the travel speeds to be exactly the same for all the speeds. And we had to make sure that the seam is printed from the shortest path. If we alter any of these settings, then the wall starts chattering. So what is exactly the problem? This is not the core of the problem. These are just settings that we chose to circumvent the problem. So it seems that when the nozzle needs to travel randomly and start the layers from different random points, it's unable to start the wall layer from exactly the same point, and that gives us these chatters in the wall. So basically, so even with these wall qualities, I still pondered if there is something that kind of breaks the wall, and I decided to print infill. And I printed cubic infill because the cubic infill generates each layer of infill at a different point, and that will shift the nozzle starting and ending point constantly. It will be a constant random shift. And lo and behold, once you introduce that type of problem, then the printer cannot print correctly anymore. It still gets these wall chatter. So let's check out, this is cubic infill right there, and it's a 0.32 layer height just to finish this cube faster so I can get the results. And if we kind of put this into the light like that, we can see these shiny lines that go diagonal. These are where the lines from the infill connect to the outer wall. And then I decided to kind of shift and print the outer wall first. I think travel equals wall. That's just the speed equals, so basically the speed is exactly, the travel speed is exactly as the wall speed, and that seems to improve, but we still get these artifacts, we still get these lines, but then the wall may not be as thick, so that could probably be mitigating with a thicker wall. And the thicker wall here, it seems to continue to still have chatter, but we get less and less lines that are protruding through the wall from the cubic infill. So technically speaking, it seems, or I don't know if it's technically or philosophically speaking, but it seems that the 3D printer, when it has two axes traveling at the same time, then it kind of creates chatter in the wall, because I really don't know why that is. There could be a slew of reasons why, when you have two axes traveling at the same time, then the 3D print will have chatter in the wall. After printing the cubic infill, and with the knowledge gained from the previous cubes with the diagonal lines, I kind of realized that when two axes are involved in traveling, then the walls are going to start to chatter, and the 3D print is going to come out with chatter in the walls. So it seems that if you print 3D cubes when only sequential axes are involved, then the wall quality is good if you follow the settings that I am talking about, which are travel speed equal over all speeds, then the shortest seam, then you get good quality wool. If you involve two axes at the same time while printing, then you get chatter in the wool. And we proved that with the cubic infill, because it randomizes each start point over each layer, so that created chatter. Then we tried to invert the outer wall with the inner wall, and that worked and it didn't work. So it seems that there is a problem. So because of involves two axes traveling at the same time, the reasons why this would produce chatter in the wall could be many, because it could be a lack of power. Maybe one of the motors doesn't get enough amperage to pulse properly, or maybe the motor could be pulsing properly, or maybe the GECO. So this could be many reasons why this would behave in this manner. So technically speaking, that would be a whole new set of investigations, or you know, searches that I could probably get involved with. So in order to prove my theory that if you print complicated prints, then you may get chattery walls, I decided to print a lamp. And I printed this lamp before, and as you can see here, the walls are just horror show, I would say. And then I also saw that I started having stringing problems. So over the course of this search or research into this particular printer, the CR10S Pro, and not the whole brand, just my printer, my CR10S Pro, I kind of figured out that the inner wall with the outer wall are dependent on infill travel distances and travel speed. So if you alter one, then it will affect the other. And even if you try to kind of mitigate, I still get issues, especially when I have like complicated prints like this one. And now I have returned into the problem of fixing the stringing and then fixing the outer wall issue. Again, when it involves like multiple axes printing or traveling at the same time, it seems that the arriving points are imprecise and then the starting walls are imprecise, and I couldn't tell you why this is happening. Right now I'm at the loss. So all I have to do is try to dial in the stringing and then start working with some lattices stress test to see where I'm going, and take it from there basically, because I don't know where this is going. So thank you for watching. Tune in every chance you get. I'm hoping that eventually I'm gonna figure out all these settings. I'm gonna become a master 3D printist. Thank you.